This persuasion coming not from the one that called you.
That's right. Hallelujah.
It's no way for the Lord to call you into salvation. Then to persuade you to leave.
Amen.
You make that choice yourself.
Amen.
But I believe that there's a few of you, a remnant of you, that have made up in your mind, for God I'll live, and for God I'll die. Might not be many, but there's a remnant of you. What is a remnant? Remnant is a few left over.
Very few.
That I decided to make Jesus my choice, and that settles it.
Yes.
Come hell or high water, like me, hate me.
Amen.
Yes.
This is my choice.
Yes.
I'm going to serve the Lord.
Yes.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
I'm going to serve the Lord.
Yes.
And that's not predicated on good days or bad days.
Every day.
Every day.
Yes.
I'm going to serve the Lord.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So I want you to understand the 24th chapter of Matthew.
Huh?
It speaks of great warning.
Yes, it do. Yes. Oh, yes, it do.
And even in warning,
yes,
God expresses his love concerning you and I.
Yes, he
did.
Yes, he did. Yes, he did.
Can you imagine if God didn't warn you that you, if you go down Manhattan Avenue, there's going to be traffic, and you follow and you avoid the traffic? You'll say, thank you, God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thou knowest all things.
Yes.
And thou knowest the way that I be.
Amen.
God, I'm just getting excited up in here.
Yes.
Up in here today. Praise the Lord.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
God, this word is enough to bring great excitement in a time that we're living in, when there is so much depression and so much dysfunction going on in family. If some of you would be transparent, you would say right now, I got a lot of stuff going up in my family.
Yes.
Going up in my family. Crazy uncle, out of control aunt.
Yes.
And children done gone buggy.
Yes.
The problem is that church people puts on a mask. Put on a mask.
Came out.
I ain't got into the scripture yet. So sure, some of you saw the movie called The Mask.
Yeah.
When people wear masks, they present themselves to be something that they're not.
Preach.
And the only way that you can get delivered or overcome issues is you have to be able to acknowledge, I got a few issues. This is only a part of life in humanity.
Yes.
We face emotional imbalances sometimes. That's why we have to have a prayer life.
Amen.
That we don't come out of character.
Yes.
When you feel that we're somewhat out of balance.
Amen.
Because some folk come out of character every day.
Yes,
and they start cussing and fussing. All right. You know what I'm talking about.
Yes.
You ever met anybody and say, excuse my friend?
Yeah.
Why do I have to excuse your friend?
Amen.
The Bible said, what's in you?
Out
of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
What you said, Elder Ring, I'm preaching already.
You're preaching already.
You're preaching.
I read this chapter.
All right, I want to turn your attention now to
thank you, Jesus.
The 20th verse.
Hallelujah.
22nd verse. 20 verse down to the 21st.
Okay.
22nd verse.
Okay.
Of the 24th chapter of Matthew.
Amen. Amen. We got you.
I don't care how many books you read. And I found out that most women read more than men. They love story. Books of story, detail, romance. Ain't nothing like reading the Word of God. And as you read the Word of God, young people, you pray for revelation and understanding. Because you can just look at the Word and read it, and sometimes you can get confused. So you read the Word, and then you pray for understanding. And let me tell you something. God will give you understanding according to His Word. Even as you read, have you ever been reading the Word of God and it opens up to you and you start to laughing? Because you understand the hidden mystery that lies within this scripture is enough to get excited about.
Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Speak
through
the
words. Understand it. What the particular scripture that said, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil.
Amen.
So what does that mean to you?
Amen.
As a believer?
Amen.
You can walk the streets of New York, your neighborhood, and your community, amen, and not fear. But the devil has tricked us to believe that it's dangerous out there.
But pray ye that your flight be not in the winter,
You gotta get this, you gotta get this. Pray that your flight be not in the winter.
Neither on the Sabbath day.
Here's two distinct descriptions of what was read. Winter and the Sabbath. Winter time, there are great disadvantages because of the coldness of the temperature.
Yes.
Anybody following here?
Yes.
There's something that you just cannot do as well when you're cold.
Go ahead.
You can't. And the Sabbath, now not everybody understands the Sabbath. I have been one who have had personal relationship with Jews for over 30 years, speak the language. I speak the language Yiddish and I speak Hebrew. And Sabbath, see, let me tell you about the Jews. The Jews work all week long, hard. Sister Ann knows about the Jews. Work with the Jews. They work hard all week long. But when their Sabbath comes, they ain't gonna touch nothing. Why? Because the Sabbath means rest. After God made the earth and everything therein, in 6 days he did what?
Rest.
He shut down. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, sometimes you got to shut down. Shut down. So, two distinct things here. Winter
and the Sabbath.
And the Sabbath. Don't plan your flight on the Sabbath. Read on.
For then shall be great tribulation.
I don't need no walking. I don't need too much walking.
There's too much walking in.
Read that again.
For then shall be great tribulation.
And we are entering into that season.
We have.
Of great tribulation.
Oh, yeah.
Great trouble.
Oh, yes.
A lot of things are happening surrounding the world.
Amen.
Don't be surprised. The other week that crane fell 2 blocks.
Yes.
Yes.
Oh my God. Yes.
Can you imagine a crane being that high? That is 2 blocks long.
Yes.
And it falling and you don't see it falling. Until it hits something. Earthquakes in divers places.
Yes, sir.
Oh yes. Oh yes.
Slashing the face.
Yes.
Can you imagine that you being cut in the face requiring 100 and some stitches?
Yes, Lord.
There's certain things that's happening that you cannot explain.
It's true.
All you can recognize is the signs of the time.
Amen.
That these are evil and perilous times.
Yes.
Even in perilous times.
Yes, it is.
The Bible has forestated that perilous time shall come.
It's here.
Read on.
Great tribulation such as was not since the beginning of the world.
Great tribulation. Greater than ever has been since the beginning of time.